Let us now study about the longitudinal magnification for refraction at spherical surfaces. In the section of reflection, we have studied that longitudinal magnification is the magnification along the principal axis. Now say if this is the optic axis with the center for the spherical surface and there are two media, medium 1 and medium 2. And say an object is placed which is having a small width along the optic axis. And here say we consider object distance is equals to x from the pole. And say here we take width of object to be dx. Here we can take it dx only when its width is very small compared to the object distance. Similarly here if in the situation an image is produced, which is at a distance v from the pole, which we take here as y, and the width of image we consider to be dy. Then in this situation, if r is the radius of curvature for the spherical surface, we can write by a refraction formula, we use mu 2 by y minus mu 1 by x is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. And here if we differentiate it, on differentiating we get this relation will be minus mu 2 by y square dy plus mu 1 by x square dx should be equals to 0 because mu 1, mu 2 and r are constants. Now in this situation, we can see the value of dy by dx, which is actually longitudinal magnification, or it is written as ml, the ratio of width of image along optic axis to the width of object along optic axis. Thus we can see the value we are getting is mu 1 y square by mu 2 x square. Or in terms of u and v, we can write it as mu 1 v square by mu 2 u square. This is the longitudinal magnification. It is used as a width of image along optic axis is equals to longitudinal magnification multiplied by width of object along optical axis. Now, if width or thickness of object and image are written as TO and TI, then this can be written as TI by TO, or we can also write WI or W as width of object and image along principal axis.